the prime importance being given to these equations as Yogi Adityanath decides on the members of his cabinet. And Times Now gets you the inside details. We've got the names now that we can definitively put out for our viewers. Jitin Prasad has been given the cabinet minister's post. Paltu Ram will be a minister of state. Chhatarpal Gangwar is also going to be an MOS. Sangeeta Balwant Bind is also in the list of inductees. Dharamveer Prajapati, Sanjeev Kumar Gaur, Dinesh Khatik have also made to the list. Very interesting is beyond the names, the caste equations that have been addressed here. So while Jitin Prasada is a Brahmin, I can see that there are at least two people from the scheduled caste, and then there is one from the scheduled tribe. There is also a Kurmi leader in the new mix. So Yogi Adityanath there expanding his team and keeping in mind all the caste equations there. And Mohit, coming back to you on that, break this down for us.
Yeah. Well, you see, we know for a fact that how Jitin Prasad is said to be a big Brahmin face in Uttar Pradesh and specifically in Western UP. He gets a cabinet berth. Remember, there are 54 ministerial positions that are there, that are as of now occupied in Uttar Pradesh. Six more you can add because you can have 60 positions in Uttar Pradesh. Now, one cabinet post was vacant and that has been given to Jitin Prasad. And we know for a fact that how all the caste equations have been worked up by the BJP, and they wanted that a Brahmin face. And there has been demand from the various quarter. Brahmin face should be given prominence, and hence Jitin Prasad has been given a cabinet rank. This is something we can break off our viewers. And we also know that Paltu Ram, who is from the SC community, he gets the Balrampur, from the Balrampur, and Chhatrapal Gangwar, Sangeeta Balwant, Dharamveer Prajapati, Sanjeev Kumar Gaur, Dinesh Khatik. Now, Priya, if you remember, when the cabinet expansion at the center took place on 8th of July, seven ministers were inducted from UP, keeping in mind the UP elections. Mm. We know for a fact that how 80 Lok Sabha seats are there in UP, and it is said that the road to the center government goes via UP and BJP. We know for a fact in 2014, 2019, they got massive support from the people on the ground in Lok Sabha elections, and they formed the government, and hence all the caste equations are being worked upon. The Dalits are given the representation in the newly and in the new faces. The OBCs are also given representation in the new inductees, because given the fact that we know that how OBC, specifically various sections of the OBCs, have been supporting the Bharatiya Janata Party. Now, when the cabinet expansion at the center took place, there were four ministers from the OBC, two from the Dalit community, and one from the Brahmin. So that is why all these permutations and combinations are being worked upon. And we know for a fact that how, if you talk about UP, UP is a very complex state. I mean, you need to talk and to carry forward and walk with every single community, right, over there. And hence, we know that last month we saw that Yogi Adityanath was in Delhi, Swatantra Dev Singh was in Delhi. Right. They had meeting with Amit Shah. Around 4 hours that meeting took place, and it was all decided then. And now the final list has come out, and official oath ceremony.
And we have also started getting first images from the governor's house, where the swearing is scheduled to take place at 6 p.m., which is roughly around 15 minutes from now. If I could request PCR to play out the latest visuals that we have got of the new ministers, the new inductees that are going to be taking oath and join Yogi Adityanath's cabinet. Meanwhile, I'm told that my colleague Amir is also joining us for more details. Yes, Amir, as we show our viewers the new inductees, do you think Yogi Adityanath has got the equations right?
Well, absolutely. At least that's the view of the government and the party. In fact, which is why there has been a lot of dilly-dallying over the last several months, and a lot of meetings that have taken place with the top functionaries within the organization as well as the party, from Delhi till Lucknow. And finally, they've come upon these seven names. One of them, Jitin Prasad, of course, coming in from the upper caste Brahmin community. Rest, three of them coming from different backward castes. Mm. And two of them coming in from Dalit quota, as well as one from the scheduled tribe. You know, all of these leaders are, pretty young leaders. Most of them first-time BJP MLAs. They have worked for the party in their regions as well as to gain votes from within their communities, which is why it seems that in view of the coming assembly elections, the party finally, thought that these names should be put forward.
One of the names that was doing the rounds earlier as front runners was Sanjay Nishad. But now, while we know that he's been nominated to the Legislative Council, he's not been included. Give us more perspective on that.
Well, Sanjay Nishad had various parleys with the party from Amit Shah to JP Nadda to various meetings with the organizational heads here in Lucknow. But it seems that the party was finally inclined only to offer him an MLC seat and obviously not giving him a cabinet berth or getting him into the Council of Ministers, because Sanjay Nishad had not minced his word over the last several months. In fact, about 2 months back, when cabinet expansion for the central government actually happened, he then also actually wanted his son Praveen Nishad to be included into that as a minister. So he was particularly unhappy about it. He also conveyed it at various levels. Also, while speaking to the media, he was quite categorical, saying that we will back up the BJP in the coming assembly elections, but it has to deliver somehow or the other our representation. It has to be seen in the government, whether at the central level or the UP government level. But it clearly seems that the BJP is not inclined towards showing any more offerings to him. And therefore, one MLC seat, it seems that the organization found out, will be fine for him. In fact, there are others from within his own community,
right,
who have been offered similar posts from...
One wonders, Amit, if this has something to do with the extremely controversial statements that were made by Sanjay Nishad in the sting that was conducted by Times Now and Nav Bharat earlier, where he said extremely inflammatory remarks when it came to Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath. But still, an MLC post there for Sanjay Nishad, and we have other inductees also. Times Now has gotten you those pictures and their names first. We'll continue this broadcast on the other side. We take a very quick break right now.